The Tar Heel State, North Carolina, is at it again with its efforts to suppress your vote. And for that reason, we knew it was time for another installment of This Week in Voter Suppression. On Wednesday, the Republican-led House approved a bill that will require voters to present a state-issued photo ID. The bill now moves to the Senate for approval. And it's the first of seven, yes, seven voting measures that North Carolina lawmakers will decide on this year. But voting rights advocates are fighting back. That includes a group of college students who silently protested during Wednesday's House vote. Joining me from D.C. to talk about the latest developments is Judith Brown Dianis, co-director of the Advancement Project. Hi, Judith.
Hi, Melissa. How are you?
So what the hey is going on in North Carolina? What is happening right now?
Well, you know, Republicans took over the state legislature in 2010 with the help of a wealthy donor named Art Pope, and they hadn't controlled it since 1870. And since then, they've taken over the governor's office, and so they have gone buck wild. They've decided to basically take what was one of the best election laws in the country and just dismantle it piece by piece.
So
I think
they really
want to make it harder.
That's so important. I want to push on that a little bit, because the point is that North Carolina actually is one of the states that was doing quite well, right? The Advancement Project sort of monitors the states, and this is one you would have put in your green column, right? Like doing well.
That's right. That's right. We're talking about 65% turnout. They had same-day registration during 1 week. You know, they have early voting, but now they've decided to roll it back. Again, it is partisan manipulation of our voting laws to make it harder for people to vote.
So why? Why now and why in North Carolina? Why go break something that is working?
Well, you know, the Republicans waited till they could control the legislature and the governor's mansion to be able to do this. And so they're setting it up for 2016 to make it harder for people to turn out so that they will have a total impact on the upcoming election.
Well, let me ask a naive question. If Republicans want a majority, why would they want to keep people from being able to vote? What is it about the voter ID or about the felon disenfranchisement rules, these seven different rules that they're putting forward that
right.
make it partisan?
Well, let's take one of them. One of them is that they will take away one of the early voting weeks. 70% of African-American voters in North Carolina vote by early voting. They want to take away the Sunday early voting, two Sundays. And the reason that they're doing that is one legislator said, because I think that there are certain things we shouldn't do on Sundays. And one of them is voting. And we know that blacks vote on Sundays two times more likely than white voters in North Carolina.
So I am having this this imaginary moment where we would have like a sky North Carolina blue wrestling match, and it would be between Art Pope and Reverend William Barber, who I know
Ooh,
is fighting.
I like
wouldn't
that idea.
Wouldn't that be great? Like I see it in claymation or something. But so explain to me. I know Reverend William Barber is on this. Who is pushing back against this?
Well, I mean, so you have, you know, Reverend Barber from the NAACP is really kind of leading the way, getting other ministers to push back against it. And then, you know, there's Democracy North Carolina. There are a number of organizations. But now, because the legislature, the Senate has passed this, we're going to see an escalation in efforts. We're going to see the NAACP of North Carolina really aggressively pushing back on this, because we know that this is all about making sure that it's harder to vote for certain people who turned out in record numbers in North Carolina. The Republicans want to make sure that they hold power in that state and that they control everything. And we're not going to let that happen.
Judith, thank you. Thank you so much for joining us. I greatly appreciate it. We're obviously going to be keeping our eyes on this, as we always do on this issue of voter suppression, because it's in these off years that the big stuff starts to happen.
That's right. Thanks, Melissa.
Thanks. Thank you to Judith Brown Dianis in Washington. And coming up next, this is a two-hour show, folks. We're only halfway through, and we got big news about news, why some of the nation's biggest newspapers could be under new management, and why you should care. Plus, Dave Zirin is on fire about the Steubenville rape case when we're back.